Hello from ABA Tech Show 2018 in Chicago. I'm Sharon Nelson.
And I'm John Simek. Today our guests are, I'm going to ask them to announce who they are.
I'm Gyi Tsakalakis.
I am Erin Gerstenzang.
And we're on the road with Legal Talk Network.
And we're back. Thank you so much for joining us on the road in the Windy City. Today we're talking about...
Well, we have some questions. So the first thing we'd like to ask is for you to give us a real brief guest bio. Gyi?
Sure. So like I said, I'm Gyi. I live here in Chicago. I'm a licensed attorney, but not practicing. I founded AttorneySync, which is a digital agency for law firms back in 2008, and help lawyers use the web to attract and earn more business.
So I am Erin Gerstenzang, and I have a criminal defense practice in Atlanta, Georgia, and I'm a solo practitioner, but I am also passionate about legal ethics, legal technology, and I get to travel around the country speaking to lawyers about those topics.
All right, so now the $50,000 question. Yikes. And no, you don't get $50,000. just tell our listeners generally, what was your session about today?
So we were talking about online reviews, and it's an area of law or area that lawyers really struggle with, because in the last 5 to 10 years, it's become such a critical part of any practicing attorney's practice, frankly, any business practice. And it's something that, you know, as individuals, we haven't all caught up with the times and how to deal with them, how to get them, and what to do when you get a negative review. So that's what we focus on today.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I can't stress enough that the conversations that people are having when they're considering hiring a lawyer and dealing with their legal issues, a lot of these conversations are taking place online. And as lawyers, we need to be listening to what these conversations are and providing excellent service to clients so that they go online and sing our praises so that our next clients see that when they're looking online for lawyers.
Well, that all makes a lot of sense to me, but here's what our listeners love. They love that one practical tip that they can take home and put to use. So why don't you each give us a practical tip?
Sure. So I would be focused on Google My Business. If you haven't verified your Google My Business profile and found ways to send happy clients to Google My Business, it's the most visible place for searches on your name in Google. That would be the top of my list.
So you just Google that, right? You
just Google My Business or go to google.com/business. You can find it there too. But you can also just Google it.
So one tip for lawyers dealing with negative reviews, it's a very emotional thing, and most attorneys have a negative review and it's a real problem for them. So carefully thinking about how you're going to respond in dealing with them. In today's age, you have to respond. So responding in the right way with the right tone is really, really critical. So take time, phone a friend, get other people's input. Don't try to respond yourself.
Okay, these are too good. So we got to do one more for me to you. So Gyi, you're up first.
Okay, so another thing that I've been focused on is encouraging people to get permission and consent for video testimonials. So video is a much more rich experience than just the written word online. And for your next client to be able to see your happy clients talking about you and talking about the experience that you provided and the service that you provided is a really great way to win the attention of your next client.
That's super.
One of the things that lawyers struggle with is they think that they don't have control over the kinds of reviews that they're going to get. And so focusing really and thinking about your relationship with your client and thinking about the experience that they have, that it's not just a result-oriented kind of process. They're not just looking for that result, that win in court. What they're looking for is the other 364 days of representation where they're treated well, where they have an attorney who's thinking about what experiences they're having, because almost all of the online reviews are driven by the experience and not about the actual result that attorneys deliver.
Great, great tips there. Well, before we close it out today, I have one last question for both of you. If our listeners would like to follow up, how can they reach you?
So they can feel free to head to AttorneySync.com, AttorneySync.com, or they can email me at Gyi@AttorneySync.com. I'd be happy to answer any questions anybody has.
And you can reach me on almost any social media channel at ehglawfirm.com, or you can email me directly at erin@ehglawfirm.com.
Well, sadly, we've reached the end of the road for today's episode.
I want to thank our guests for joining us, Gyi, Erin. We also want to thank our listeners for tuning in. If you like what you heard, please find and rate us in Apple Podcasts. We'll see you next time for another episode of On the Road with Legal Talk Network.
If you'd like more information about what you've heard today, please visit LegalTalkNetwork.com. Subscribe via iTunes and RSS. Find us on Twitter and Facebook, or download our free Legal Talk Network app in Google Play and iTunes. The views expressed by the participants of this program are their own and do not represent the views of, nor are they endorsed by, Legal Talk Network, its officers, directors, employees, agents, representatives, shareholders, and subsidiaries. None of the content should be considered legal advice. As always, consult a lawyer.